Hey, are you okay?
I want to make music, but I don't know how.
Hello world, it's Siraj. In this episode, we're going to talk about the bleeding edge in machine-generated music, then write our own music generation script in TensorFlow in just under 90 lines of Python. I'm a big fan of Hans Zimmer.
Don't leave Matthew McConaughey, no.
But I don't have the time to put in 10,000 hours to be like Hans. But just imagine a program where I could say, I want a song that conveys the feelings of hope and wonder while sailing the seven seas, but also the gaseous feeling of eating too many beans. The program would convert that speech to text, then for each word, it would find the associated vector. It would then compare those vectors to vectors created by a model trained on a labeled music dataset for a range of human emotions. The output of the machine would then be a set of chords that it thought best represented those emotions. It would lower the barrier to entry for me to compose music. Machine learning is a layer of intelligence that is meant to extend our own. I'm still really bad at folding shirts. A laundry folding robot would be so dope. DeepMind released a paper a few days ago called WaveNet, which is now the state of the art in both music generation and text-to-speech. Traditionally, audio generation models are concatenative. That means in order to generate speech from some text sample, it utilizes a huge database of speech fragments by picking a few and combining them to create a full sentence. Same for music. This works, but it's hard to incorporate things like emotion and natural sounds when the output is created by putting a bunch of static fragments together. Ideally, we could have audio generation that is parametric, where all the info required to generate audio is stored in the parameters of the model that we give it. That's what WaveNet is capable of. Instead of generating an audio signal by passing its outputs through signal processing algorithms, it directly models the raw waveform of the audio signal. Researchers don't really do that, but WaveNet did. The model they used was a convolutional neural network where each layer had dilation factors that let its interconnectedness grow exponentially the deeper the data flowed through the model, and each generated sample at each step was fed back into the network to generate the next step. Let's take a look at the computation graph for the model. The input data, a single note, starts as a raw audio wave. We first format the wave so that it's better suited for processing, then we encode it to produce a tensor with a number of samples and a number of channels. We feed that into the first layer of the convolutional network, which reduces the number of channels for easier processing than through a stack of layers with dilated convolution. We combine the outputs of all the layers and increase the dimensionality to the original number of channels, feed it all to our loss function, which measures how well our training is going, and finally the output is fed back into the network to generate the wave at the next time step. This process keeps repeating to generate more and more audio. This neural net was huge. It took 90 minutes on their GPU cluster to generate a single second of audio. Instead, we're going to build a more simple music generation script in TensorFlow. We want to first import NumPy as our scientific computing library in Python, then Pandas as our data analytics library, then of course TensorFlow, our machine learning library. TQDM will help us show a progress bar during training, and finally mid-eye manipulation, which is our helper library. Let's start off with the first step, our hyperparameters or tuning knobs for our model. We're going to use a type of neural network called a restricted Boltzmann machine as our generative model. An RBM is a two-layer neural net. The first layer is visible and the next layer is hidden. Nodes within layers are connected to nodes in the next layer, but no two nodes of the same layer are linked. That's the restriction part. Each node decides whether to transmit any data it receives to the next layer or not by making a random decision. We want to first create a range of notes that our model will generate, so we'll write variables for our lowest note and our highest note, as well as a note range, which is the difference between the two. Then we'll write variables for the number of times, the size of the visible layers, the number of hidden layers, number of training epochs, batch size, and finally our learning rate, which is a TensorFlow constant since it always stays the same. Next, we can write out variables. We'll start off by creating a placeholder, which will serve as our gateway for inputting data into our model, then a variable that will store the weight matrix or the connections between our two layers. We also need two variables for biases, one for the hidden layer and one for the visible layer. We then want to create a sample from our input in X using our Gibbs sample helper method. Gibbs sampling is an algorithm that creates a sample from a multivariate probability distribution. It constructs a statistical model where each state depends on the previous state, then uses randomness to obtain a sample across the distribution it creates. We'll get a sample of the hidden nodes as well, starting from our original input, and a sample of the hidden nodes starting from our generated sample. Then we'll update our weight values based on the differences between the samples that we drew and the original values. We will run these three update steps for our weights, hidden biases, and visible biases when we later run our session, and we can store all of these in our update variable. All right, it's time to start a session so we can run our graph. We'll initialize our variables first. We're going to reshape each song so they are vectorized in a good training format. Then we're going to train our RBM on the examples one at a time. Once the model is fully trained, we will make some music. We will run our Gibbs chain where the visible nodes are initialized to zero to generate a sample, then reshape the vector to be the proper format for playback. Finally, we'll print out the generated chords. dope. The state of the art in music generation uses a CNN to generate raw waveforms parametrically instead of concatenatively. That algorithm requires lots of compute right now, so we can use an RBM to generate audio samples based on training data easily. And Gibbs sampling helps us create audio samples during training by randomly obtaining them from a generated probability distribution based on the input data. And so the winner of the last coding challenge is Rohan Verma. He created an image classifier for astronomers to classify galaxies as either elliptical or spiral. Badass of the week. And the runner-up is Chih-Cheng Liang for creating a bird classifier for biologists. I bow to both of you. The challenge for this video is to use the RBM script to generate an audio sample with a happy, upbeat sound. Post your code in the comments, I'll judge them and announce the winner in my video 1 week from now. For now, I've got to get more silver hair dye, so thanks for watching.